The United States Geological Survey, USGs, posted an update on Kilauea on Thursday, August 30. Their statement read, "Seismicity remains low and ground deformation is negligible at the summit of Kilauea Volcano. On the volcano's lower east rift zone, LERZ, no incandescence was visible in the fissure 8 cone nor was there any lava entering the ocean during an overflight yesterday. The lack of lava suggests the eruptions from the earthquakes may finally be subsiding after its massive eruption on May 3. Last week Hawaii was battered by Hurricane Lane, which was downgraded to a tropical storm on Thursday and poured more than 44 inches of rainfall over parts of Big Island. Will the floods cause more earthquakes and eruptions from Kilauea? Bill McGuire, a volcanologist and emeritus professor of geophysical and climate hazards at University College London, does not believe last week's floods will cause more eruptions or earthquakes from Kilauea. Professor McGuire added some tropical storms similar to Lane can bring low atmospheric pressure, which can contribute to a volcanic eruption. He told express.co.uk, "There is plenty of evidence for small changes in the environment triggering volcanoes, and earthquakes, landslides and tsunamis. Some eruptions at Montserrat's Soufrière Hills volcano have been related to torrential rainfall associated with tropical storms. This infiltrates the volcano, comes into contact with the magma, and triggers explosive blasts." Fascinatingly, the coastally located Pandlaf volcano in Alaska tends to erupt when low pressure weather systems raise adjacent sea levels by just 10 to 15 cm. With the eruptive activity at Hawaii's Kilauea volcano apparently over, residents of Big Island have been talking about the ongoing challenges they face as they try to put their lives together in the face of the enormous destruction caused over the course of the last 3 months. Community organizer Jason Twillman and Pastor Matthew Purvis have been at the forefront of efforts to help the more than 2,000 people who have been evacuated as a result of the eruptions, and stressed that it was a community effort, with minimal help from the state or federal governments. In a video widely circulated on Facebook, Mr. Twillman said, "It's pretty overwhelming for a lot of people right now. The pressure is ongoing and the uncertainty is just really making people frail, including myself." The clip included footage of a community meeting at which frustrated residents vent their anger at representatives of various local agencies, and Mr. Twillman added, "This is not a vacation. It's every day we have to wake up and figure out how we are going to get through the day and figure out where we are going to get any help. Who is helping us? Are we going to get any help or do we have to help ourselves?" Members of the community have really stepped up to do that. "Nobody really has all the answers. My goal is to work with as many community members and council reps and leaders as I can and go forward with this." Mr. Purvis said, "There has been a huge outpouring using social media for what it is really best for, crowdsourcing, information, maps that have been put up that were completely done by individuals that show each house that has been burned down." He said the community had banded together to build temporary shelters for people left homeless after the destruction of more than 700 properties on Big Island, adding that this had been done by members of the community without help from the government at any level. However, he acknowledged the assistance of 60 members of the National Guard, as well as donations from local businesses. He added, "We see here an example of what can happen when people cooperate." Hawaii's Kilauea volcano seems to have slowed down in its activity, but is the eruption over? When could Kilauea's next eruption be? A lava pool located at the most active fissure on Hawaii's Big Island has disappeared, according to scientists. The U.S. Geological Survey, USGS, released a report detailing the lack of lava at Fissure 8 in the Lower East Rift Zone, LERZ. Previously, this fissure had been supplying a channel of lava which had entered the ocean at Kapoho Bay. The resulting reaction caused toxic clouds of lava to rise from the ocean, potentially causing serious breathing impairment for those who came into contact with the mixture of steam, glass and acid. Is Kilauea eruption over? The lack of lava seems to suggest the volcano is slowing down in its seismic activity. In their report, the USGS said, "Seismicity remains low and ground deformation is negligible at the summit of Kilauea volcano. Earthquakes, probably aftershocks of the magnitude 6.9 earthquake in early May, continue on south flank faults." On the volcano's lower east rift zone, A small lava pond was visible deep within the fissure 8 cone on Saturday morning, but lava was no longer visible in the cone yesterday morning or during UAS flights later in the day. There was still a single small lava dribble which was oozing lava into the ocean from the Kapoho Bay lobe spotted on an overhead flight by the Hawaii Volcano Observatory, HVO, on Monday morning. The recent impact of Hurricane Lane across the Hawaiian Islands had little effect on Kilauea, say the USGS, apart from minor rock falls at the summit and increased steaming from Pua with Macron and LERZ events. The sulfur eruptions have been reported to be at their lowest level since 2007. The USGS said, sulfur dioxide emission rates at both the summit and LERZ are drastically reduced. The combined rate is lower than at any time since late 2007. Many will be hoping that this decline in activity is the end of the eruption for the explosive volcano, which had been erupting since May this year. This statement follows HVO's decision to reduce the alert level for ground-based hazards from warning to watch. This means that the volcano will still be closely watched as the Hawaii Civil Defense warned reactivation could occur at any moment. The government organization said, while eruptive activity is minimal at this time, hazards remain. It is common for eruptions to go through periods of diminished output, or to pause completely, only to reactivate days, weeks, or even months later. Reactivation can occur at any time, with little to no warning. Hurricane Lane is set to reach Hawaii imminently, sparking fears it will add to the devastation caused by the Kilauea volcano on Big Island. A shocking wind map shows the hurricane of the century slowly moving towards the U.S. islands. The Hawaii hurricane, which was downgraded to a powerful Category 4 hurricane on Wednesday, is set to make an impact on the southwestern tip of Big Island. The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, NOAA, predicts the storm could unleash up to 30 inches of rainfall on Hawaii, as it ravages the Pacific Islands with 145 miles per hour wind speeds. The NOAA 5 a.m., 4 p.m. British Summer Time, update warns Lane is creeping closer to Hawaii, as torrential rain is soaking the Big Island. The storm is currently 210 miles, 335 km, south of Kailua Kona, and 305 miles, 490 km, south-southeast of Honolulu. Category 4 hurricanes have strong winds between 131 and 155 mph and are strong enough to ruin buildings and make permanent changes to the coastal landscape. The powerful storm is slowly tracking toward the islands at 7 miles per hour, and areas under hurricane warning are the Oahu, Hawaii County, and Maui County, including the islands of Maui, Lanai, Molokai and Kahoolawe. Kauai County, including the islands of Kauai and Niihau, are under hurricane watch. The slow movement increases the risk for prolonged heavy rainfall, strong winds, flash flooding and storm surges. The NOAA satellite's feed warned, the slow movement of the storm increases the threat for prolonged heavy rainfall. Hurricane warnings are in force on Big Island and Maui, while hurricane watches have been issued by the National Weather Service across the rest of the state. Lane is a rarity because even though Hawaii is in the middle of the Pacific Ocean, very few hurricanes have actually made landfall there. According to the NOAA's historical database, only a few hurricanes have passed within a few hundred miles of the islands, most recently Hurricane Hector earlier this month. No hurricane has made landfall since Iniki lashed the island of Kauai in 1992. Big Island, where residents have also been having to cope with the eruption of Kilauea volcano until activity fell off at the beginning of August, has never been struck since modern weather records began. Forecasts suggest that even if Hawaii avoids a direct hit from Hurricane Lane, southern parts of the state could still face damaging impacts. The NOAA uses the GOES-15 satellite, 22,000 miles above the Earth, to track hurricanes in the United States, Western South America and much of the Pacific Ocean.